up, everybody? Today is Wednesday, July 8th. We're less than a week away from the start of Q2 earnings season on Wall Street, and investors are bracing for perhaps the worst reporting season since the 2008-2009 global financial crisis. According to FactSet, Q2 S&P 500 earnings will plummet by a jaw-dropping 43.8% when compared to the same period a year earlier. Revenue expectations are equally unsettling, with sales growth predicted to fall by more than 11%, which would mark the biggest year-over-year drop since the third quarter of 2009. So for my weekly post for Investing.com, I highlighted the three sectors you want to stay away from as Q2 earnings season kicks off. The first one is the energy sector, which is expected to report the largest year-over-year drop in Q2 earnings at an astonishing 148%. Revenue is expected to fall by more than 40% as lower crude oil prices weigh on results from the sector. The two energy companies expected to report the largest year-over-year decline in earnings are Marathon Petroleum and ExxonMobil. Another notable name set to suffer a substantial reduction in Q2 earnings is Chevron. On to number two, elsewhere. The consumer discretionary sector is expected to report the second largest year-over-year earnings slump at a dismal 119%. Revenue is expected to fall by almost 20% as the effects of COVID-19 really impact and hit results from the sector. Some of the hardest hit companies in the group are likely to include Wynn Resorts, Norwegian Cruise Lines, and Royal Caribbean Cruises, all reeling from the impact of the COVID-19 crisis. Automakers will also see their earnings tumble, with General Motors and Ford as the two to monitor. And finally, number three, the industrials are projected to report the third highest year-over-year slump with a drop of almost 90%. Revenue is expected to fall by more than 27%. And at the company level, watch out from earnings from the airlines. Delta, Southwest, and Alaska Air are predicted to be the largest contributors to the decline. So stay tuned for that. We do get results from the banks next Tuesday as earnings season kicks off. Stay tuned. Be sure to check out Investing.com's earnings calendar for all the big releases. Have a good one, everybody.